Patel and Nehru had many differences, but they were not enemies. They were not even rivals. They were colleagues with very profound differences, but with many more profound agreements. And this question, of course, is very thoroughly discussed in my book, Biography of Patel. When Mahatma Gandhi was killed in January 1948, Patel was the Home Minister, also the Deputy Prime Minister. There's a newspaper called The Statesman, which was published from Calcutta and Delhi at the time, and it had a letter to the editor 2-3 days after Gandhi's assassination that Sardar Patel has failed to protect Gandhiji's life, he should resign. And another man made the same statement, famous man called Jayaprakash Narayan, that Sardar Patel should resign. So Sardar Patel wrote to Jawaharlal Nehru that what the statesman letter to the editor says is correct. Jayaprakash, what he says is also correct. I should resign. He wrote the letter, but he did not send it. He wanted to wait a bit. Within an hour or two, a letter arrived to him from Jawaharlal Nehru. I'm not quoting the exact words. My dear Vallabhai, we have been together with each other and with Bapu for so many years. We have had our differences, but other people are magnifying our differences, exaggerating them. We must now stand together. Now it is all the more important for us to work together. I promise to you that I will be loyal to you, and I know that you will be loyal to me. And Vallabhai Patel was deeply moved by this, and he wrote a wonderful letter in which he said that, of course, we have done this for so many years and we will stand together. Then they had many differences on many issues, continued to have, but they never broke with each other. And the different perspectives are very helpful. You know, if everybody says yes, 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 but different people provide light on other issues, different issues. October 2, 1950, this is 2 months before Vallabhai Patel's death, October 2, Gandhiji's birthday, there is a meeting in Indore, and something to do with Kasturba Gandhi. And Vallabhai Patel makes a very moving speech. I don't have the exact words. And I'm sure All India Radio has this somewhere, because by this time, Patel was not only Home Minister, he was INB Minister. All India Radio, so they would have recorded it also. The newspapers published it. He said that, these are his words, talking about Bapu and Ba, that Bapu and Ba gave me more love than my own parents did. Then he said, I am where Bapu posted me. You people call me Deputy Prime Minister, that means nothing to me. I am Bapu's soldier, I am doing his duty. Then, Bapu said that Jawaharlal Nehru will be the leader after him. Many years ago he said it. And I am obeying him. I am not disloyal to him. And what Gandhi said was right, that Jawaharlal Nehru should have been Prime Minister of India. Now, people may say, oh, Patel is trying to flatter Nehru. But Patel had many weaknesses, but flattery was not his weakness. He never said things he did not mean, not once. This was Patel's considered view. So those who want to portray the Nehru and Patel as enemies, and that somehow Mahatma Gandhi fooled the people of India, he foisted Jawaharlal Nehru, everybody in India wanted Patel as Prime Minister, it's not true. Go back to 46, 47, 48, find any newspaper in any language, in any part of India, where anyone says, oh ho, I wish Patel had been Prime Minister. Not one person said that at the time. Yes, afterwards, when there were many weaknesses, and when Indira Gandhi and emergency, many people began to make criticisms of Nehru. Some of them may have been justified. But to say that the people of India wanted Patel as Prime Minister at the time and not Nehru is completely untrue to history. If people of India wanted it, at least there should be some record of somebody expressing a grievance, oh, I wish Patel had been Prime Minister. On Sardar Patel, that he was nominated by many Congress committees. He was nominated for what? Not for Prime Ministership of India. In early 1946, there was a discussion, who should be the next Congress president? And many people said that Jawaharlal Nehru has been president three times, Maulana Azad has been two times, Vallabhbhai Patel has only been once. Vallabhbhai Patel is very old, he is not well, he was the hero of the Quit India movement, which is, they are now released from prison. We must make Vallabhbhai Patel the president of the Congress. So various Congress committees proposed his name. Some proposed the name of Acharya Kripalani. Somebody proposed the name of Pattabhi Sitaramaiah. Nobody proposed Jawaharlal Nehru's name. Yes, the matter came before Gandhiji. Rightly or wrongly, maybe wrongly, but it is a fact that there was a convention by this time that people will propose, ultimately Gandhiji will decide, and whoever he decides, we will vote for him. This, rightly, let us say wrongly, but this was the convention. Gandhiji decided that, said to Maulana Azad, Maulana Azad wanted to stand again. He was president from 1940 to 1946. 3 years between that were spent in prison. He wanted to be president again. Gandhi wrote to him a letter in Urdu saying that I feel you should not stand. In my opinion, Jawaharlal Nehru should be the president. I have my own reasons. I can tell you if you want. I don't want you to stand. He said to Vallabhbhai Patel, withdraw. And this amazing man withdraws. Kripalani also withdraws. And Gandhi says Jawaharlal Nehru should become the Congress president. So, whatever, it was not to become Prime Minister. So, one of the men who was very actively for Vallabhbhai Patel to become president at the time was Dwarka Prasad Mishra. You must have heard his name. He was the leader of Congress in what was called Mahakoshal, Jabalpur, part of Madhya Pradesh. He has written, when we proposed Vallabhbhai Patel as Congress president, all of us wanted Jawaharlal Nehru to be Prime Minister. But we wanted Sardar Patel to be honored for his great life service as Congress president. So this is the factual reality. What you say that yes, Gandhiji, it was left to him, may have been a bad thing. Now it's maybe left to Rahul Gandhi or Congress leadership to decide between in Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh. We may disagree with it. When Indira Gandhi was defeated in 1977, the leadership question was left to whom? Jayaprakash Narayan, Acharya Kripalani. They were asked, please select somebody. Moraji was in the field, Jagjivan Ram was in the field, and Charan Singh was in the field. They left it to. So their logic was, or those who accepted this logic was, yes, nomination or selection after election does not look very democratic, but election can produce very deep divisions and can destroy whatever has been achieved. So according to them, selection was at that stage a lesser evil. Sardar Patel statue is now touching the sky. Not only is Nehru left behind, but Gandhi is also left behind. Patel is much, much, much. But, you know, why compare one against the other? Why should we judge, is Patel greater than Nehru, is Gandhi greater than Patel, is Nehru greater than Gandhi, is Subhash Bose greater than everybody, is Ambedkar greater than everybody? Why should there be comparison? Why should we not be proud that we had all these fantastic stalwarts? That is my understanding. You know, when I was 21, I learned this important lesson in life. Proceed not by comparison, but by appreciation. It has helped me in life. Not comparison, but appreciation. Comparing others with you, others with one another, not needed. Just appreciate everyone's good quality.